Hello, and thank you for joining me today with our Mango Voice tutorial. My name is Tyler, and today we're going to be talking about how to set up your own call forwarding. Now, in order to set up your own call forwarding, you are going to need a username and password to log into our website. Once you are logged in, this is the dashboard that you're going to see. Now, we're going to head over to the switchboard first, as this is where we're going to be setting up our call forwarding. And then you'll need to identify what switchboard you'll be using today. Now, if you don't know which switchboard you're supposed to be using, you'll go to the My Numbers tab and identify the number that you're setting up the call forwarding for. Once you've identified your number, you'll identify the endpoint on the right-hand side of that number, and it'll tell you the endpoint. You'll go back to switchboards and look for that endpoint. 1000 is the endpoint we're looking for today, so we're going to enter switchboard 1000. Now that we're in here, we see our traditional switchboard. Now, a switchboard can look very different than this, but don't worry. Setting up call forwarding is easy regardless of your switchboard. So the first thing that we need to do is locate the external transfer button towards the top of the page and click on that external transfer. Now, this object is your call forwarding. What we're going to do is we're going to place it somewhere on the board. Once it's placed on the board, right here where it says number, we will want to enter the phone number that we are forwarding to. Once all 10 digits are entered into that switchboard, you'll then go with the other settings. We have timeout, which is how long the phone is going to ring. Now, the default is 30 seconds, but you can change this anywhere that you would like to a maximum of 300 seconds. The pass-through caller ID. With this enabled, that means that you will see the caller ID of whomever is calling you, making it difficult to identify if this is a personal or a business call. To help with this, we like to disable the pass-through caller ID, and all calls will automatically use the caller ID selected here instead. If you have a variety of numbers, any number on the account can be selected here. And that'll help you identify business from personal calls. Require one to connect. With this checked, when the call is forwarded to you, you will hear a message saying you are receiving a call from the office. Press one to connect. Once you do press one, you'll start speaking to that person as if you had answered the phone. Now, what this also does is this ensures that Mango calls stay inside the Mango system. If we were to disable this, it is possible that your cell phone or home phone takes ownership of the phone call, and voicemails can be left on your personal device as opposed to the Mango system. This is why we like to leave this checked. That way, all messages will be left in the Mango system. Now, after you've gotten the external transfer set up to your liking, you can minimize it here to save some space in your switchboard. Now, all you'll need to do is direct the call flow to that object. Now, you can do that by moving any line to that object. You just need to identify the proper line. All calls begin right here at start and will follow the lines appropriately. So if you would like all calls to be forwarded to that cell phone number, you'll move that line to the external transfer. And from there, we will move this line to the voicemail. So voicemails can be left in the Mango system. Now, if you don't want all calls forwarded to your phone, you'll move a different line. Let's say you just want the calls for the open hours. So we will move this line for the open hours to the external transfer. And at this point in time, as soon as you click the Save button in the top right-hand corner, all calls will be forwarded to that cell phone. And it's as simple as that. And that's all there is to it. Thank you again for joining me today with your Mango Voice tutorial.